another great opportunity from God towards you and I. You might think it is just normal to be among the living. You might think it is just one of those things, but I want to tell you that you and I are privileged. Privileged to hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Privileged to hear this glorious gospel. God wants you to know that this gospel is the most important thing. This message you're hearing is the most important thing. This is not a news on TV. This is not some broadcast that will pass away in a couple of minutes. This is the message from the Lord God. And what you do with it will determine your eternal destiny. You know, the subject of eternity is something many people like to brush aside. Many people like to focus on what they can get in the temporal. How to get a nice show, the nice stuff, the nicest of everything. My friend, that is all good. But God wants you and I to be concerned about our eternity. My friend, eternity lies ahead of each and every one of us. Eternity lies ahead of you, my friend. And someday, God knows, only God knows, my friend. It might be tonight, it might be 10 years from now. It might be 20 years from now. It could be tomorrow, who knows? But my friend, God knows. Someday, each and every one of us, we're going to stand before God's judgment throne, and what a moment that will be. That moment where you are all by yourself. That moment when it is all you and God. That moment where every phase of your life will pass right before you, and every secret things will be brought to light. My friend, what a fearful moment that will be. I think that is the moment you all should be concerned about. That is the moment you and I should be concerned about. Care little for what every man writes about you on earth. Care little about what your closest friend think about you. But I will tell you, do not despise what God thinks about you. God knows the end from the beginning. God knows that moment. He knows the end from the beginning. And in his great love, my friends, Jesus came into this world. Jesus came into this world to save every sinner. You know, let me say something. The title sinner doesn't look appealing, but there is nothing to be ashamed about, because as far as God is concerned, the best of all is put in this class. The most righteous man on earth, the most well-mannered man on earth is still included in this rank. God calls everyone a sinner. But Jesus came into this world to save every sinner who would trust in him. Jesus came into this world because none of us could save ourselves. Jesus came into this world because of the great love with which he has me. My friend, it cost him everything to come into this world and to save. The most important thing God wants you to do is to think about your current estate. You know, if you have a bank account, if you have riches, from time to time you monitor what goes in and what goes out. But I tell you, there is something that is far more important than anything in this world. It is to consider your condition before God. It is to consider your state. And my friend, God, in his own wisdom,